Kim, what do we got in the inbox today for Miss? I'm excited.
We have a lot of questions, but there's one that's kind of interesting. It's a little different than what we've been looking at lately.
Mm-hmm.
So this particular scientist wants to know about sample preparation.
Ew.
So what we do to the sample before it goes into the liquid chromatograph.
Woof.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know much about that, Kim.
So they are looking to simplify their sample preparation a little bit, and they think, or they want to know rather, if all polymeric solid phase extraction sorbents are water wettable, so they can skip some steps.
Huh, so this is SPE, huh?
Yes.
Ooh, outside of my comfort zone. But I'm excited to take a look at this myth.
All right, so for this one, I think what we should do is take a bunch of different polymeric mm-hmm. solid phase extraction sorbents and run the same analyte on them.
Okay.
And since they specifically want to know about water wettability, I think we should try them with conditioning and equilibration steps, which are included in traditional solid phase extraction,
yeah.
but then also try them without the conditioning and equilibration steps to see if there's any performance difference.
Okay.
We should look at recovery. We should look at reproducibility.
Wow.
And then we can determine, I think, whether this myth is true or not.
So you're talking about before we put the analyte into the blue boxes, we got to do
yes.
something to them?
Yes, we do. You can't Ooh. Just take a piece of pizza and stick it into the LC. It doesn't work that way. You have to
pizza.
Do something to get the extract out of the pizza.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Okay, let's go.
All right, Kim, well, let's recap what we did with these little 1cc cartridges here.
Sure. So what we did was we tested four different polymeric solid phase extraction mm-hmm. sorbents to see if they were water wettable. So we ran each one in triplicate.
That's right.
And we ran them with the condition and equilibration steps to
yep.
properly wet the sorbent first. And then we ran in a separate experiment where we ran them without the condition and equilibration. And we also ran them under extended vacuum to see what degree those solid phase extraction sorbents would de-wet.
Great.
And we should be able to tell from the data whether or not the sorbent is truly water wettable, even though it's polymeric.
Let's go look at the data.
Let's go.
Well, Kim, I gotta say, that was pretty awesome. I mean, I couldn't even spell SPE, to be quite honest. I'm glad to say, instead of using pizza, we use plasma.
I'm glad we didn't use the pizza. I liked it for lunch.
But again, we got the results. I learned a lot about sample prep. And let's walk through these results real quick.
Yep, let me show you what we got. So we can see in these results, we took a look at four different polymeric SPE sorbents. And what we did here was we did the traditional protocol that you would use where we used condition and equilibration. You typically use condition and equilibration to wet the sorbent first.
Mm-hmm.
And we can see that all of these sorbents worked pretty well. We have high recoveries, they're pretty reproducible.
Mm-hmm.
But the real point of this was to test water wettability, right?
Right.
So in our second experiment, we ran these same sorbents without the condition and equilibration
yes,
steps.
Yes, I remember that.
And what we can see here is that one of the sorbents worked really well, which would indicate that it's truly water wettable,
mm-hmm.
but the other three did not. They have much lower recoveries, and the big problem here is that they have much greater reproducibility issues. These error bars, the RSDs, were a lot higher here.
Yeah, I can clearly see that. I mean, the one that's 100% water wettable performed much better than the other ones.
Right. You can imagine how this might play out, too, when you're doing an experiment in the lab, right? As
yeah.
you saw when we were in the lab, you've got the wells or cartridges flowing at different rates. So if one's just drying out under vacuum or positive pressure, you might have the same kind of problem with reproducibility.
All right, Kim, this has been a really cool myth because, again, I'm learning a lot about SPE here. So what do you think really makes one of these phases water wettable?
Ah, so that's a good question. And what we can see here, if we look at Oasis HLB, for example,
mm-hmm.
that is actually a true copolymer. It's made of N-vinyl pyrrolidone and divinyl benzene.
Oh, cool.
It's stable over the whole pH range of 1 to 14.
Mm-hmm.
But the real key here is that it has this polar hook and it has a hydrophobic retention. And what that enables it to do is be truly water wettable. So it grabs onto that water and it doesn't dry out. Actually, in another experiment, we tried drying the sorbent out. We let it dry under vacuum for half an hour and it didn't dry out.
Oh, wow.
So there's a big difference in performance, and it's safe to say that not all polymeric SPE sorbents are created equally.
Yeah, I can see that for sure. All right, Kim, so let's try to bring this back home here. So the original myth was, are all polymeric SPE sorbents water wettable?
So I think I'm going to split my answer on this one.
Yeah.
And say it's not true that they're all water wettable, but some are. So it's important to know which one you're dealing with and make sure that it is water wettable, because that'll give you the highest degree of reproducibility and performance.
So how do you want to call this myth?
I'm going to call it part true, part busted.
Ooh, so how about plausible?
Plausible. I like that. If you'd like your question to be answered on a future episode, please feel free to email us at trustyoursciencewaters.com.